गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस कंटिन्यू क्लास 6 सोशल साइंस विद चैप्टर नंबर 10 स्फीयर्स ऑफ द अर्थ। नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू रीड एंड अंडरस्टैंड एंड गेट सम इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द डिफरेंट स्फीयर्स ऑफ द अर्थ। एज we have earlier discussed that there are 4 spheres of the earth, and in this chapter we will discuss those 4 layers of the earth in detail. So spheres of the earth, there are 4 main spheres of the earth or 4 layers of the earth, that is lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere and biosphere. Now let us discuss the first one, that is lithosphere. The upper layer of the earth's surface is generally made up of soil and solid matters, and litho means soil. That is why the upper layer of the earth's surface is also known as the lithosphere. Since this layer is also made up of rocks and solid matters, and that is why sometimes it is also known as the rock sphere or the solid sphere. Now what is the area of lithosphere and its formation? Let us look at the formation and area of lithosphere. Upper layer of the earth crust is approximately 64 to 100 kilometer thick. So the very first fact that we have to remember is that it is approximately 64 to 100 kilometer thick. That is the thickness of lithosphere. Light matters like aluminium and silica are mainly found in that. So the two matters like aluminium and silica are mainly found on the upper crust of the earth's surface. That is, from lithosphere we find aluminium and silica. And lithosphere occupies about 29% of the earth's surface. So from among the total 100% of the surface of the earth, there are 29% of lithosphere. Various physical features like mountains, plateaus and plains are there on this part of land. And as we go into the depth of lithosphere, that means as we go deeper into the lithosphere, the temperature increases gradually. That means as we go below the lithosphere, we find that the temperature increases gradually. That means it rises with the deepness of the lithosphere. And on moving towards the depth, generally per kilometer 30 degree Celsius temperature increases. So for every 1 kilometer the temperature increases with 30 degree Celsius. If we go deeper and deeper inside the earth, that is in the lithosphere, we find that the temperature is increasing gradually. Internal rocks are melted due to intensive heat and turn into semi-liquid form. So the inner rocks that are there in the lithosphere, they are melted, and with the intensive heat, temperature and pressure, it melts and turn into semi-liquid form. That means the solidness is not there and comes under the semi-liquid form, and this semi-liquid molten liquid is called magma, and it consists of various gases. Many gases are there in magma, and here high pressure of upper rocks is observed. Now, what is the importance of lithosphere? We have discussed about the area and formation. Now, let us understand the importance of lithosphere. What is its importance in our life? Lithosphere has close relation with biosphere and vegetation. Our home, water, farming, industry, and all are closely related with or associated with lithosphere. Minerals and crude oil is also obtained from lithosphere. Various crops are obtained through farming activities that happens on the surface of the earth. Various industries and other economic activities are also performed in the plain regions. So these are all importance of lithosphere. Because of the existence of lithosphere, we are able to do farming and in the plain regions, and also various industries are set up, various minerals and metals are obtained from lithosphere. These are all the benefits that we get from lithosphere. Forest on the mountainous region is also adapted to the lithosphere. In short, we can say that the pillar from food to dwelling, that is from food to our basic existence, means lithosphere. So this is the importance of lithosphere. We have discussed in this video about what is lithosphere, its meaning, and also area and formation. And lastly, we discussed about the importance of lithosphere. In the next video, we will continue with the hydrosphere. What is hydrosphere? What is the total area that it occupies on the earth's surface? And also its importance.